Looks like a northern harrier. I'll have to check on that.
Yeah, I just checked the pictures. It is definitely a northern harrier. Oh, look at that. It's got a bolt. I can see the little things there. Yeah. Very cool. Now. Yeah, I see what looks like a Cooper's hawk, maybe a red-shouldered hawk. If I zoom out, you can see it. Yeah, how far away? You can see how far away it is from me. Yeah, so it's that far away, all the way on the other side of the field. Over, like, across the street where there's no place for me to walk, so this is about as close as I'm gonna get. All right, after some careful examination at the pictures, I found out that this is actually a red-tailed hawk. Yeah, I mean, you can't really see it very well because it's just so far away from me, but there it is. Alright, continuing on now.
Okay, there it is. Okay, red-tailed hawk. And it goes over those trees. And the sun is blaring. I cannot see. Hey, look at that. American kestrel. I'm not really gonna bother filming this thing for long. Because I still need to eat my lunch. Kestrel's alright. It's just enjoying itself right on the top of that tree. It's far enough from me that even if I were closer, it probably wouldn't make any difference. I'm not really gonna try to get too much closer, but oh, look at that. It's pretty cool. I didn't have time to get my monopod out, so I'm just laying here on the ground filming this American kestrel. Yeah, so there it is. Alright, gotta move on. Oh, and there it goes. Bye-bye. Bye-bye, American kestrel. See you next time. Alright, so I'm on a different section of the park now. I just got out of my car. I'm now going to go through these woods and eat my lunch over in the field over there. Alright. Alright, so I'm now walking through the woods right here. No hawks over here. No. Just going to be eating lunch just wherever I feel like it. Right over there. And I do see some birds on that tree bush right there. I know you can't. Yeah, not quite as interested in cardinals as I am with hawks. They actually totally bore me. Yeah, they do. Yeah, I'm not interested in any songbirds. Nope. I just figured I'd show that anyways. Alright. I don't want... And they already flew away. Go figure. Yep, not surprised. Oh wait, there's a hawk. And I don't know where it's at now, because it went through those trees there. But that's alright, at least I got the footage. Yeah, there we go. Thank you. American kestrel. And look where it's at. It's around the top of those trees right there. Right next to that playground right there. Where some kids are playing at. Yeah, look at that. So yeah, there's the kids on the playground. Okay. And then right on this tree right here, you can see this kestrel. I'd love to get closer to it. Question is, can I? That is so beautiful, it really is. The sun is just making a perfect, perfect image of that American kestrel. I just can't believe how beautiful that is. Wow. Totally wow. I'm gonna see if I can get closer and grab my monopod out, alright? Take a look at this. There's actually a full moon right there. Like, look at that moon right there. That's so beautiful. And then as I go down here, sorry, we can see the kestrel. I am a little bit closer to it this time. Whew. So we'll see how long I can film this thing. Starting now. The tree branches are kind of blocking the view a little bit. I'm gonna change my angle. I'm gonna change my angle just a little bit. I guess that's a little bit better. It's just a pain to record this thing without a tripod. Damn. I can tell this kestrel is less fearful of people than the other one that I saw on the trail. I need to zoom out just a little bit because I need to get my other thing. Hang on a second. About the shakiness. It's only gonna be shaky for a minute. It's not as great as the monopod, I admit it. Alright, this isn't working. Alright, so I was actually using this thing. I know you can't see it well because I'm zoomed in, but it's this contraption right here. I'm gonna find another way. I think I almost got it. By a stroke of luck, maybe I can get it centered. And maybe I don't have to tilt this camera no more. Okay. Just a little bit further. Kind of reminds me when I was adjusting the antenna for my TV. You guys gotta get it just right, you know what I mean? To get the best reception. This is the same exact thing. Don't focus in on the tree branches, focus on the bird. Still need a better angle. The focus is bad because of those stupid tree branches. Hang on. It's just not good enough. It's preening itself, and it's looking around at the same time. It's like a person's head on a bird of prey's body. Yes, I'm serious. It's got eyebrows and everything. Like, look at its facial features. It's kind of got stripes on its cheek. Kind of looks like, I don't know, like some of those markings that the Indians had or something, you know, hundreds of years ago. Stuck sticking its foot in. Must be cold. Oh yeah. I'm just filming this American kestrel that's up on the tree there. Yeah. Yeah, she's wondering why I'm just laying down on the grass here. Yeah, it's because that way I can sneak up on this raptor right here. Yeah, there is another American kestrel close to the parking lot that I tried to film. But it flew away right when I laid down. This was the other day. The same thing happened today, too. Earlier. But yeah, a guy that is also a photographer, he walked past me and he's like, you have to sneak up on them. Because if you walk too fast, that flushes them out. So, that's exactly what I did. And here I am. Filming this kestrel for more than 20 minutes now. Yeah, can you believe that? I have a feeling that it's gonna go. Not quite yet, okay. crap. Focus, focus. Focus is bad. I don't know what button I just pressed. As soon as I zoomed out, I totally screwed everything up. Oh man, there it goes, and it's going all the way.